in tag team action against Buff Bagwell and Scott Norton, Rick Martel and Booker T for the TV title. And then here to come tonight, later on in this program, Hollywood Hogan and the Macho Man, Randy Savage, against Sting and Lex Luger. Can you imagine they would sign this match this close to Super Brawl?
They're in complete disarray. This is a good night for WCW.
It certainly could be, Larry. You're exactly right.
Nothing positive. It is.
Doesn't get any bigger than this high-profile tag team matchup in the main event tonight. And you're right, Tony. Tony, receiving a message?
Yeah, Wendy Turnbuckle handed me a note right here.
I never get a note.
And said that Bret Hart has just arrived at the arena.
Bret Hart is in the building tonight.
How about that?
You could have gave me that note. I read that note.
Well, she hands it to me first. If I want you to say it, I'll hand it to you.
I don't want to read it after you palmed it.
Nevertheless, I didn't expect to see Bret the Hitman Hart here.
And remember about Professor Bischoff and Professor Hogan and their College of Wrestling Knowledge. The B standing for Bret Hart. And Bret Hart, we understand, has just arrived tonight.
And I don't think there's any question that there is a B in their list. It should be Bret Hart because he's the catalyst to all the bad things that have happened to the NWO. Let's not forget when this great program was in Memphis, Tennessee, near the end of 1997, how they came out with the Canadian flags. They tried to sing the Canadian National Anthem. They all thought that their money had brought Bret Hart here. But Bret Hart is tradition. Bret Hart is WCW. They know that, and that's why they put him on their list, so to speak. It's good to have him here. Glad he's here tonight.
You can only buck the system for so long, and sooner or later, tradition will rise up and bite you.
It's going to be La Parca against Yuji Nagata, and these two men know each other quite well, Mike, today.
Well, they sure do, Tony. I see La Parca. We call him the chairman of World Championship Wrestling. He brought the chair to ringside. The last time they hooked up, La Parca nailed not only Yuji Nagata with the chair, but also the Disco Inferno.
And Yuji Nagata taking this frustration out on La Parca as he has chopped him down many times. La Parca with a great kick in the back of the head. And we've been told now that Ric Flair has arrived in the building. I tell you, the closer you get to mega events like Super Brawl, and when you have a mega tag team main event like we have here tonight, the big stars are going to come out for it.
And the intrigue grows. What part will Bret Hart, what part will Ric Flair play this evening on Nitro? What a punch off the top by La Parca, crashing down to Yuji Nagata on the floor.
Everybody seems to be just flying in, and La Parca just flew in too.
And then just tattooed Yuji Nagata with that open hand slap.
Up on top now, La Parca. La Parca with a big crossbody block. Nice roll through that time by Nagata. Hooking a far leg and getting a two count.
Couldn't hold him. Yeah, Nagata saw it coming, rolled through real nice with them. Just couldn't hold him down.
Nice blows with the back elbow. And he runs right into a lariat. Well, La Parca showed a great deal of great anticipation that time. Sent him down and she now with a great lariat, only got a two count though.
Well, La Parca hit Yuji Nagata with a little bit of everything from his offense and high risk move on the way. La Parca out to the ring apron, taking his time, however, as he goes up to the top rope.
Whoa, too long!
And that backfired. Big splash off the top, does not connect. Yuji rolls through, caught him in the head with the kick.
And Yuji Nagata wasting no time. This is what you call being on top of him, staying aggressive like you always preach, living legend.
Well, you've got to stay aggressive. I mean, here La Parca, biggest of the luchadors, if I'm not wrong, trying to go toe-to-toe with Yuji, who's a big guy, and they couldn't hold him down right there, but not using the flying techniques, wound up on the mat. Yuji got that one leg in the wrong place.
And Yuji has the cross arm breaker applied to La Parca, but...
Yeah, but he had his leg underneath, couldn't get it above the chest.
And also, luckily, La Parca was close to the ropes.
Now back in the quarter, Nagata with forearm shots in the jaw. Nagata sending La Parca other side. The masked man held his ground. La Parca in, back body drop. He landed on the outside. And a shoulder block into the midsection.
Look how quickly to the top. Corkscrew off the top.
The corkscrew flying body attack was on target, but he's not finished yet. He went looking for the chair, went to the wrong side, could have cost him, but he's got his weapon now, guys.
Those corkscrews will get them semicircular canals in a dither. You don't know where you're at. He found the chair.
And Now with the chair is Sonny Ono. And who's this? It's the Disco Inferno.
Chair buster on La Parca.
Disco Inferno, like you said, he was nailed by the chair by La Parca in that match not too long ago as well.
Well, that's payback, and here comes Nagata. There's the Nagata lock if he drops back. There it is.
He's got the Nagata lock on, and La Parca has to tap out. Well, the Disco Inferno has proved to be an ally of Yuji Nagata here tonight. But I tell you, that is just a little payback for Disco Inferno here, guys.
Yeah, I don't know if he's an ally. I think he's out for himself. Definitely has a vendetta against La Parca.
You see? That true champion from Japan.
Well, we have people arriving here right and left, like the Nature Boy Ric Flair, like Bret the Hitman Hart. What impact will it have on tonight's big main event? We're going to take it back one.